Nothing to react about. I think it was very, very good and very cordial, and very respectful of the president to call us from his region, because as you know that this region has been supporting the president overwhelmingly. We look forward to the next few years in this country. I think we are at a very definitive period as a country, and some things you cannot run away from them for so long. So we want to thank him, and we look forward. He has promised us some engagement going forward. We do hope that we are going to go together without any blame game. We do not want to blame the president for anything, but neither do we want also him to blame us as governors, as MPs. We just hope that we are going to have a very cordial and collaborative, because it's a team effort that is going to be in play. I'm also very satisfied that he has promised that we can be able to look at the issues of BBI with an open mind, because that's a problem really, that some people have been peddling as if some things are fait accompli. We do hope that everyone will have their right, majority will have their way, and minority will have their say. Yes.
What other issues has the president addressed?
Of course, we have got our traditional issues here, mostly issues of agriculture, our coffee, our tea. We were here in 2016, and I'm very sad that even from the speeches, whatever we said here in 2016 is the same thing we have said today. You would assume there are some people who will come from mass to solve the problems. I hope we will not be here in 2023 talking about the same things. So we want to see some action.
True.
Yeah? But there's nothing new I've heard today, even from all those leaders. The same thing, we were here in the same tent in 2016, and we talked about our coffee, nothing has happened. We talked about our tea, nothing has happened. We talked about potatoes and all the other issues. You know, this is a region that is very heavily dependent on agriculture. There's no other way of feeding all these millions of people in this region. And we do hope that the good words and the positive comments of the president will be matched by action, especially by those people in whose hands he has entrusted the most important dockets. And I'm very sad to say that the cabinet secretaries who have got the responsibility over the issues we are discussing today, they are from this region. So I hope they're also listening. Yeah? Because it is very sad. We talk about coffee again and again. Actually, there has been a lot of progress in coffee, but only in the amount of coffee that task forces have consumed in big hotels. That's the only progress we've seen.
Mahesh, we're told there was a bit of concern on who was on the program to address today's meeting. Perhaps is it a concern you have had? Is it a concern you share that a particular faction was chosen to address the president?
It's not really about, I will not be concerned about who speaks, because the issues are the same. I don't know what else would have been said differently. We need roads, we need water, we need electricity, we need to be paid decent price for our milk. So it doesn't matter whether who said it was from which faction or what faction, the issues are the same. So really, I wouldn't want us to dwell on who is in the program or who is not in the program. What we should dwell about is, why are we repeating the same things we said in 2016 today?
So Mahesh, final question from me maybe, is you are among the people who said that it's time we went to Nyuma ya Hema and speak. And the president having called this meeting, especially at a time when people are also talking about succession politics, do you think all issues were addressed that you would have wanted?
You cannot address our issues in 2-3 hours. So what I want to take positive is that the president has said that we'll go to the counties. Because you know all these issues, they appear to be the same. But when we go into the detail, that's where the problem lies. And by the way, let me declare here, as a member of parliament, I've got 100 million shillings a year. There's very little you can be able to do with that, and we try to do our best. And equally for governors, you know, if you look at Kiambu County, for example, my county, Nakuru County, which are the highest from our region in terms of money, if you get 10 billion shillings and you decide to do roads, you can only do, you know, 300 kilometers of roads, or less, 200 kilometers, yeah? And you look at a county like Kiambu. So we still need, and that is why our numbers are important, so that as we bring 15% of resources to the counties, 85% is left in Nairobi. And so, yes, I need to account for my 100 million. My government need to account for 10 billion. But we have got trillions in the national government. That's what we want to trickle down here.